Our new parts have completed without issue. They'll be on the car ready for the next race weekend. From me. Your workstation should be all set up and good to go, but if you run into any issues, be sure to give me a shout.
Back finally to the hustle and bustle of Formula One. The F1 2023 World Championship is about to get underway. We cannot wait to get started. Last season saw the biggest raft of regulation changes in years, and we're excited to see more of that wheel-to-wheel racing. The big question is, though, can anyone challenge the dominance of Max Verstappen and Red Bull? Well, all the teams have been working so hard to get ahead in the development race, looking not only at their own car, but those of their competitors. Thousands of engineers working hard back at the factory. We come to the racetrack and we focus on the 20 drivers at the pinnacle of motorsport. But it's important to remember this is very much a team game, and watching that technical battle unfold throughout the year will be fascinating as everyone looks to get to grips with these new regulations. Meanwhile, the F1 World Tour features all the classic highlights. Monaco, Silverstone, Singapore. Great to see all those iconic tracks back, but also a few surprises. Qatar is back after a year away, and the inaugural Las Vegas Grand Prix. The glitz and glamour of Vegas, flat out down the world-famous strip. I know all the drivers have been so excited about this one ever since it was announced. Okay, that is enough from me. Let's get cracking with the action.
Season, but this is where we get the real data from the real car on the real racetrack. So as many miles as you can get done consistently over these sessions, the happier we're going to be. We'll be right back. Okay guys, everyone be aware, the car's ready to go. Okay, we've only got one lap of fuel remaining. That's Yuki behind you. Okay, so their best lap time is at 1:32.6. That's just 30 seconds left in the session.
Months of rumour and speculation all come to an end today as we return to racing for the opening event of what promises to be an enthralling season. Welcome along then to round one of this year's Formula One World Championship. We go racing today around the 3.36 miles of the magnificent Bahrain International Circuit with 15 corners and two good passing opportunities into turns one and four. Keep an eye out for drivers locking the front left tyre into the tricky braking zone of turn 10. It's time to take a look at our starting grid for today's race. Max Verstappen put in a fantastic lap yesterday, and he'll start from pole position. And it's Charles Leclerc in P2. Looking down the rest of the grid, we have Perez, Sainz, Hamilton, Russell, Fernando Alonso, Norris, Stroll, Magnussen, Bottas, Gasly, Joe, Hülkenberg, Ocon, Albon, Tsunoda, Moore, Oscar Piastri, and Logan Sargeant. And now it's time to head down to the track. A new season then, a clean slate where anything could happen. Anthony Davidson is with me today as once again we get another year of Formula One underway.
We're into those tense few minutes before the first race then. Everyone's a little bit nervous about reliability. They haven't been running in the hot, turbulent wake of other cars in practice, and they've not been pushing at 100% for long durations. Let's hope no one has to deal with any nasty surprises.
Okay, here we go. I know what you can do. Don't let me down. Okay, pull the clutch in. Hold it there until the start. Right, feed in the throttle. Let's build the revs. We're not seeing any technical issues coming off the practice starts. Watch the RPM on the full start. We don't want you to bog down. And that's the end of the race. We'll see you in Parc Fermé.
It was a magnificent race and a drive right out of the top draw to take the win for Red Bull today. And talk to me, what do you think it was that sealed the win for them?
I feel like consistency was probably the key today. There's being quick and then there's being quick lap after lap after lap. If you can do that, you can capitalise on other people's errors without making many of your own. And that's an approach that can push you a long way up the field.
Here come today's winners. The team at Red Bull have done a phenomenal job recently, and it's clear to see that they've put in the work, and they should be so proud of the victory they've secured here. Standings have changed. Max Verstappen's excellent result today sees him take over as the new leader of the Drivers' Championship. So, Anthony Davidson, who would you rank as your driver of the day?
I have to give it to Moore. There was a lot going on all down the field, but they were the only one who I really felt maximised their potential.
It's time to see how things are shaping up in the Constructors' Championship. And Red Bull take over as championship leaders. It's been an absolutely wild weekend of Formula One action, and I can't wait to see what's next.
You handled that well. Thank you. Expecting some new developments to come through, but some of them have failed quality control. We'll need to tell the team what to redevelop via the R&D screen.